Hi, my name is Don Elwell. I am one of the five Highlands County Commissioners, Commissioner for District Number 2. And April is National Child Abuse Prevention Month. It's a time when child wellness and welfare is the most important thing you can think about the entire month. All community members have a role in ensuring children have positive life experiences. And by reading this book, I hope to help our children lead healthy and happy lives. It's okay to look dumb every once in a while as an adult. It actually kind of makes it a little bit more real for the children. And let's help prevent child abuse before it happens. All right, the name of my book and the book that I think was chosen especially for me is Pig the Slob. It's written by Aaron Blabey, the New York Times best-selling author. And as I go through, you will understand why this book I think was hand-picked for me. So we will start at this time. Pig the Slob. Pig was a pug, and I'm sorry to say he was shockingly lazy. Such a shameful display. He lived in a flat, horizontal position. Truly appalling condition. Full of candy and soda and thick mozzarella, lots of pizza. Pig was a hardcore, full-time sofa. His only exertion was swiping a screen. Swipe, stare, repeat was his grueling routine. Sure, once in a while he would lift a remote, but it made him quite tired and his ankles would bloat. Flat on his back, he'd relax, binging on TV, chicken nuggets, and pie. Pig duck in deep, he was part of the couch, an immovable lump in a warm, sticky pouch. Sounds a little disgusting, but Pig was obviously not much of a doer. Trevor was worried. Pig's health was at risk. We should take a quick jog or a walk, nice and brisk. Pig stirred from his stupor. His reply was quite tart. He simply said no and then unleashed a... Well, you can kind of figure out what he meant there. It rhymes with tart and starts with an F. Okay, it was fart. I said it. Anyway, we'd have so much fun though, tried Trevor once more. That was a suggestion that Pig chose to ignore. From a bunker of sloth and with no sense of shame, Pig returned to his ice cream and his video game. And that's when they heard it. Trevor stopped in his tracks. "What's groaning?" asked Pig. "Of snacks?" The first groan was subtle. The next one was not. The floorboards were groaning. Yes, groaning a lot. "Could that be my tummy?" asked Pig, blinking slow. Then the floorboards exploded. "Hey, watch out below," as Pig and the couch fell onto the next flat down. These days it's different. I'm happy to say Pig makes an effort to come out and play. He's up off the couch doing cartwheels and squats. He practices yoga and goes juggling lots. His workouts are great. But the part he likes best is when he gets home, he can have a nice rest. And in this case, if you look at the picture, he's also eating a turkey breast. And that is the end of Pig the Slob. Alrighty, I hope you enjoyed Pig the Slob. It was a great book. Again, kind of handpicked for me, which concerns me a great deal. But it's a good book because, you know, so many kids these days and so many adults these days, we're on our phones, we're watching TV, we're doing everything except getting out and playing like we used to do when we were little and we were young. And so it's probably a good idea to have a little bit of balance in there and get involved with your kids if you can. Get involved with the children, teach them to get outside a little bit, teach them that there's a whole big wide world out there and outside of Netflix and outside of their video games. You will get a lot closer to your children, your children will get a lot closer to you, and you'll have a little bit bigger perspective in each other's lives going forward. My name is Don Elwell, and again, I certainly appreciate you all listening to me read Pig the Slob to your children.